think it's this, because of this they call the French froggies. So it's my first night again in froggy country. A real nice lawn here. Some apple trees or whatever. Yeah. And I have to go to the dentist because I've got no money, and in France they help you. You know, in Switzerland it's only for the rich, you know. Nobody helps you. They only try to steal your money. But in France they never stole my money in France. The police never did. The French people help. So no matter what problem I have, they help me. They help anybody. France is good. Just never gone to Switzerland. So I found a real nice place last night. You can hear the motorway there. You hear? So full of chemtrails. And well, the lawn has been cut very nicely. And it's a sort of a pond behind here. I can't see the screen. But anyway, I have to go to the dentist. There's a nice church. I'm in Alsace. I'm going to film the where the crash happened of the Airbus a month ago. And see what I can film for you after I had my teeth done. I've been having a toothache for 3 months now, and the whole area hurt. You know, I had to take painkillers and everything. In Switzerland, they just, you know, they make your life a misery, so you can't work. You know, they don't give you a permit, they terrorize you, put you in prison, steal your money, so you cannot go to a dentist. Nobody helps you. You know, it's all big money over there, terror and big money. But in France, you know, they help, you know, so I have to go for like a homeless thing, you know, for the homeless in here in France. Was that a cherry tree? Cherry blossom. Nice. Spring is one of the, so it's April and I think 20th or 21st. Spring is really one of the nicest moments to travel. I think summer has its, you know, its charm as well, and of course winter as well. You know, sleeping rough in the snow really, really does something, you know. Nice. So, yeah, well, the gate is closed, so that this is where the Frenchies, the froggies were last night. Get him. No. What's the name again? Dandelion, isn't it? Forgetting all the English names. Nice. Like a, you know, like a campsite. Look at the lawn. Clean and soft, you know. And I can walk around here. Oh man, all the gear I'm carrying, you know, it's, you need this, you need that, you know, it's so much. Incredible, you know. It's a wolf, you know, you can sleep everywhere, you know, but as a human being, all the gear you have to take, it's incredible, all the things we need. So I can film you that one. So it was a real agony, you know, the last 3 months with that toothache. You know, I could feel it going in my ear, in my eye, you know, the pain. I had to take painkillers and I couldn't get away for the moment. So, you know, the Swiss, they just let you die, you know. You can die of a toothache, you know, all the poisons getting into your blood of a dead tooth. And, well, they would be glad, you know, that I would, you know, just die. They would be very glad. End of problems. That's Swissy, eh? So, yeah, I could even feel it like going down through my neck and the whole region, the whole jaw, you know. So after each meal, I just cleaned it very thoroughly with a toothbrush and a little toothbrush, sort of. I'll show it to you in a minute. And so I could just, you know, stand it, sort of, you know, just around the limit. And this is going on for 3 months now. I had to look after the children, you know, the little girl, and so I couldn't go away. So I had to sit in pain. Yeah, there are a lot of videos to do. So for 3 months, you know, just next to the toothbrush, I had this little brush here, and I cleaned the gaps, you know, and this little pick here, and I just cleaned it, and I, you know, so I could, you know, the worst pains I could avoid like this. Yes, I know this is Fluor toothpaste. Where does it say? It says fluoride. Some people, many people out there say it's not good. Well, I think it's brilliant. You know why? It is brilliant because it is poisonous. It is a poison. And this is what I need. I want a poison to kill the bacteria in my teeth, you know? I don't think, you know, I wash my mouth out, and anybody washes his mouth afterwards. So, you know, it protects. So, you need a poison to protect your teeth. You need a poison to protect your teeth. You get it? You can't just do it with salt. You know, you get holes. And actually, the Arabs, they have a sort of a plant from Saudi Arabia, which they use with for thousands of years, you know, in the Middle East. And they analyzed it, and you know what? You know why it worked? Because it has a high amount of fluoride in it, in the plant. That's why it works. So don't be too paranoid, you know, and keep thinking, you know. Not everything what's there is bad, you know. Not everything is bad. Fluoride for your teeth is good. Believe me, I think it's good. You know, one of the arguments on the internet, and you know, that fluoride is bad, is they say it makes you dumb, you know, like a slave. Well, I tell you, I'm just as dumb as I was before, you know, with using fluoride. So it didn't make me any dumber. I'm just as dumb as I was before. So, you know, and I mean, you can see me, you know, I'm not a slave of society, you know, as far as I can manage, you know, to enslave myself. So, and I'm using fluoride, you know, so, well, there you go with your argument. I'm just as dumb as I was before with fluoride. Didn't make me any dumber. But okay, then there is the issue of fluoride in your drinking water. That's bad. That's really bad. This is what you should avoid. This is really the problem. Fluoride in the drinking water. Fluoride in your toothpaste is good because it's a poison, it kills. And you want something that kills all the bacteria and things attacking your teeth. You need to kill it, you see, for your teeth. Kill the bacteria. So you need a fluor and a poison. Get it? But not in your stomach. You know, it's the same thing with my last video about the real alien caught on camera, you know. It's, you know, I'd like to keep my feet on the ground, you know. And, well, let me ask you. And then everybody, just with, like, with the toothpaste, everybody's screaming on my channel, oh, it's a hoax, he's lying, I'm gonna unsub. You see, I finally have the proof. Everybody's looking for the proofs, you know, so they can prove a conspiracy or a hoax, you know. Everybody's out for hoaxes. Well, when I'm going to the crash site, I'm going to show you, you know, that's not a hoax. The plane really went down, but there is a conspiracy. I mean, that's the difference. So concerning my real alien on camera, you know, I thought it was quite funny. let me ask you something, you know. Why do you think I left a couple of clues, like, well, I had a beer with the alien. Don't you get it? Yeah. And that's for my my loyal subscribers. I left a couple of clues, you know. And I left another clue when I said, well, it wasn't the anti-terrorist police from Switzerland. It was only an alien. I mean, who would say this? It's just an alien. Don't you get it? Don't get hysterical, please, will you? Not about the fluoride toothpaste. Not about, you know, about the Airbus crash, which I'm going to show you. Keep your feet on the ground and keep a sense of humor, you know? And the funny thing is, you know, that considering all the different nationalities watching my videos, it was only the British, you know, the English, that understood that it was a joke, you know. There are other countries, you know, like the Swiss, you know, if there's a joke coming up, you have to tell them, well, listen, there's a joke coming up, you know, otherwise they don't understand it. And this is the same thing with that my real alien on camera, caught on camera, you know. And I had a couple of other reasons for doing it, you know. I was so, you know, pissed off, you know. I'm putting a lot of work in all my videos, you know, real lot of work. For my last video about the Teutonic Knights, which I put all together on my channel, Gure, 2-hour video, and I even had more footage, and I couldn't get it in because I can only upload until 1 hour, up to 2 hours. So it took me 3 weeks, 3 or 4 weeks. Well, if you count the time, you know, that I put all the information like slowly together, it's of course it's years. But you know, making the video and put it took me 3 or 4 weeks. And then if I see all those people, you know, having like millions of views, you know, or 10 millions of views with a, you know, a real alien caught on camera, you know, and if you click on it, it's just another loss of time, you know. So I thought, well, let's have a practical joke, and I put a few clues in it for the for my real subscribers, the ones, you know, the real truthful subscribers who will, of course, they will understand it. But I was mistaken, you know. Not so many understood it. Just a couple of them from the UK understood it, because you know it's in the culture of the UK, you know, and also in South Africa, you know, you do practical jokes, you know, you don't say an alien, and you see the alien, you know, like trying to get into the door, and you see, you can hear like in a Hollywood movie, you know, the door handle moving. There was another clue actually. So there were at least three or four clues in it I left you, you know, like yeah, so you would understand, you know, like in a real crime story, you know, like an Agatha Christie sort of thing, you know, murder on the River Nile. Well, it is all has to do with the River Nile and the pharaohs. So I left a couple of clues so you would understand, you know, but it is a bit disappointing that most people didn't even understand this, you know, and you get all those hate mails in a shit storm, you know, like it's a hoax, he's a liar, you see, I finally have the proof he's a liar and all these sort of things, you know. So yeah, and I'm sort of pissed off, you know, with all the cheap videos on the internet, you're just losing your time, you know, real alien caught on camera. So I thought, well, let's see how many views I'll get if I put that title in. And at the same time, for my real viewers, I leave a clue so they'll understand, and they that it's why, you know, it's just, it's a parody. The name for it, it's not a hoax, it's not a lie, the name is a parody. You have to differentiate, you know. It's not only just black and white, you know, there's also, as they say, 10 shades of gray, or, you know, and there really is. It's not just black and white, you know. Well, that's in Switzerland, it's all black and white, or red and white, you know, like in the flag, or there's no gray in Switzerland, you know, it's black and white. It's evil, and they trying not to look evil and try to look innocent, you know, it's black and white. So
I hope you like my parody. So that's why I'm telling you in this video, it's gonna take a few weeks before I can upload it because I'm on the road. And so I just had to tell you, you know, that a subtle joke or a parody, you know, that, well, you understand, I just explained to you. So yeah, you know, my answer to all the real alien caught on camera, you know, and it's not real, you know, and they're just going for the views, you know, millions of views, and they're even making money out of it, you know, and I think I'm really pissed off with that, you know. So my reaction to that is not anger, it's not swearing, you know, but it's with humor, with parody, and I think that's quite British, you know. From my South African side. So for the ones who don't understand it, well, you have to understand British for that. So a parody. That's my answer to that sickening thing going on the internet. There's so much rubbish, you know. And at the same time, you know, for the ones who are attracted by the rubbish, I thought, well, I leave some real in it. Some real information in it, you know, my other videos with real information, which is a mystery. We don't know really who did it, you know, and it might be aliens, you know, the ones from Egypt, as in Ari, born out of the sky. And so there is the real mystery. So I was hoping by this parody to attract, you know, those people and give them something for it, and not so they just lose their time and energy. And their hope that there are really aliens, you know, to unmask them, the hope to unmask them, that they lose the hope, you know, so give them some real evidence. So this is why I did it. It's humor, it's parody, and against that bad tendency going on, you know, of people who are just, you know, again, the only criteria is money. Make a lot of have a lot of views, make some money, you know. So this is how mankind is getting corrupted again, also on YouTube and the internet. So my answer to that is just very British, and it's parody, you know, it's British humor. Of course, you know, you silly ones, you know, of course I don't have a beer with an alien, let's invite him in, you know, it's just an alien. You know, wakey wakey, I got you there. So, enough of that. Let's go to the dentist before the aliens get me first. You see, I'm not afraid to sleep in the night, you know. I've never seen any aliens, you know. If there are any aliens, you know, they look like humans, you know, and they are genetically processed, you know, like these pharaohs or the blue blooders, you know. We are the aliens ourselves anyway, you know, we have to, you know, we can't walk around like this, our alien feet will hurt, we have to put on clothes, otherwise we're cold, you know, we have to cook everything, you know, otherwise our alien stomachs can't digest it like a wolf or a sheep eating just the grass, you know. We're definitely not from this planet, we're not at all adapted from this planet. We're the only one, you know, look at all the garbage I have to carry around, you know, it kills me, it's so heavy. I'm probably the only sort of species on the planet, you know, that has to carry so much garbage around, you know, just to survive and sleep outside. A wolf doesn't have to, a sheep doesn't have to. So we are not from here. We are the aliens. But then there are the other aliens as well, I suppose, if I'm talking about aliens. It must be, you know, logically, the ones who control us, you know. But they look like us, you know. As they said, you know, mankind was created in God's image. And that's what they probably did, the Anunnakis. Yeah. So, again, let's go to the dentist before the aliens get me first. And let's, you know, catch a real dentist on camera. You get my sort of humor now. I think subtle humor is a typical British thing anyway, you know, the rest of the world, I don't know, they don't really get humor, you know. You know, have you ever heard of, of Japanese humor or, you know, German humor or Swiss humor. Well, I haven't, you know. For the Japanese, you know, like cutting somebody's head off with a samurai sword, that's humor. Then they're laughing dead, you know. And for the Swiss, it's humor, you know, and they laugh, you know, when they can terrorize somebody and call up the cops, you know. And even the Americans, they have less and less humor. The Americans I remember, like 40 years back, or, you know, or 30 years back, they had humor. Now, you know, they're turning their state into a Swiss dictatorship, you know, a Swiss-Japanese dictatorship with Swiss dictatorship laws. Well, the Octagon Swiss sleeper agents, they're on all key positions in the US anyway. They came with the paperclip operation afterwards, and now they're going to do the same thing in the US, already doing it, as they did with Nazi Germany. It's still the same Swiss Octagon who did the same thing in Germany. And now they went to South America. They did the same thing in Argentina with the junta, the Argentinian dictatorship. Many people disappeared. I think 30,000 children disappeared. They threw them out of airplanes. They did the same thing in South Africa, everywhere. So it's a Swiss-Japanese dictatorship with Swiss total control laws and some, you know, octagon samurai guys in a black uniform, octagon US police, you know, in a manner of speaking, you know, chopping all the people's head off, you know, just gun them all down in the streets, you know. That's, we see it happening, don't we now? So there's not very much more to laugh about, you know. Humor is disappearing anyway, you know. So what I want to do, I just wanted this parody. And a parody is a type of humor, you know. It's subtle humor, and it exists, you know. And I just want to see with that title, you know, Real Alien Caught on Camera, if I can attract like millions of people and then give him some real solid information, you know, about the octagons everywhere, all the secret symbols about the United Kingdom, and then as a change, compared to all the other hoaxes, with that parody title, you know, give him some real information. So I hope to reach like millions of people and get to them, you know. So it's well, that's all. No more words about it. You understand it or you don't. You got humor or you don't. You want to change something or you don't. Yeah. Or otherwise, putting it into religious terms, we can also say God has numerous faces. God has numerous ways. So this is the town of Aspach, where I slept, where they speak Swiss German. And what do I see on the church? It's not black and white, it's even in the real colors, they know what they do. It's red and white checkerboard of the United Kingdom, of Lower and Upper Egypt, of the Per Tasser, of the Red Kingdom of Lower Egypt, and the Red House and the White House of Per Het. It's here, it's in this church. So it means this is a ecumenical church, you know, if they're showing it like this with the new, you know, the new religion of monotheistic religion of Akhenaten in white, of the White House in Lower Egypt, in Upper Egypt, sorry. And the old pharaonic multi-divine, multi-god religion in red. Now, like, and both, in fact, followed by the Masons. Yeah, so this is the small town here. I slept there somewhere. It's everywhere, you see. The Freemason checkerboard church, you might say. Yeah. Right. You see, guys, this is not a hoax. It's here. I'm showing you the visual proofs. So, I mean, why go through all the problems, you know, making this checkerboard things on it, if it wouldn't have some sort of a meaning? And even the trees here are red and white, you know, for the ones who don't understand humor and a parody, I should say. There we go. Now, of course, these are the priests of Amun, where the word Amen is from. See the Pharaoh show. The priests of Amun, this is their religious wing. And they also have the financial wing, the Swiss banks. And they have the military wing, the Templars. So, and of course, this is the religious wing. And the political wing, the Freemasons and the checkerboard. This is how they rule humanity, and they know it. You know, and this here too, with these round things on each side, with the sun in the middle, you know. This is a huge sun hieroglyph. You get it? And they know what they're doing. It's everywhere. Just right next to the Freemason church. And it's an old pit or something. It's deep. So this is the water, you know, the River Nile. There's always an obelisk usually next to the, or if there's an obelisk, it stands next to the water. And even in a little village like this, there's a lot to see. But here it's in the same village, where here it says Wilnauglow. So there was the other, the water pit, the old water pit with the sun hieroglyph in the middle. The church, the Freemason church is here. And here's another fountain. You see there are three standing up sides here for the Isis, Horus and Seth. It's always three. The base is a square, four, for the pyramid. And on top is the number four, so that makes four altogether for the four elements. And within it, you know, we can see sort of a step pyramid. You see? There's sort of a step pyramid in it. And there's that symbol, oh no, that's the water, yeah. So the numbers three and four are here, and it's two times four actually. And if I look longer, there's a lot more to see. So that's three for Isis, Horus and Seth, and four for the water, air, fire, and earth. Yeah, and there's our church again. Yeah. There's the mayor's office. Well, let's have a look at the mayor's office. Well, there's the crown, the aristocracy, the pharaohs, the mayor's office, the Freemason church, everywhere. It's everywhere where you look around there. Everywhere. Wow. Well, let's go. There's a war memorial, which you find in every French town, the First World. It sets for the First World War. And for the other way around, and the other one, Second World War. So this is the Horus Matrix, all these men, they have to die for this here. You know, for these pharaohs and the aristocracy. And you see, it gives a row of four, you see? Vertically, there's four, for the four elements. The whole line is based upon a row of four. It's all four, three, seven, you know. And so, watch my film, Fight the Enemy Within. No More Wars, Fight the Enemy Within, about the Horus Matrix, which I explained there. You see the Teutonic crosses, the same thing the Nazis had on their warplanes and their tanks, which is a Swiss cross in the middle with the Teutonic Black Cross in the in that, you know. Yeah, well here they speak Swiss German. It's in Elsass, right near to Basel. So I don't know if it's a Catholic or a Protestant church.
But there's a lot of occult stuff going on here. You know, there's everywhere the Vetica Pites of the Freemasons here. The rings, you know, the oval, like in the Oval Office. There's the Sun Hieroglyph. So I have no idea. I'll see if I can find a clue. There's a Templar's Cross. So here in Bornhaupt, Le O. So I'll have a look if I can find the. This one here is octagonal. An octagonal pyramid. There's an organ. So lots of octagons. Well, let's have a look then. If it's, to me, it doesn't matter, you know, if it's Catholic or Protestant. They all did Heil Hitler, you know, in the Nazi era. Whether they were Protestant or Catholic, it's all the same bunch. It's all pharaonic. Église catholique en Alsace. So it's a Catholic church. I don't think they would make any publicity for any Protestants. The Protestants wouldn't make any publicity for any Catholic church in here, so they showed the Nazi cross here and the rest. There's a lot of things here. Well, of course, it's a Catholic church. If there's a Marie everywhere, I know that much. It's not very much. Hey, why do you think they put this here in the garden, you know? The world domination on it, sort of an obelisk. Well, there is an obelisk. And instead of the four elements on it, look at it. So, it's not pointed. Oh, there's even a pyramid, an upside down pyramid on it, instead of the carved bit. So, well, we know who's living here. Yeah. Look at it. What do you want? Oui, c'est bon, j'attends. Oui, faites-le, j'attends. Faites-le. Oui, appelle la police. Oui, faites-le. Mais appelle la police. Vous êtes quoi, Alsacien? Hein? Malgré nous? Hein? Appelez les Gestapo? Hein? Appelez les Gestapo? Pardon? Mais oui, mais faites-le, j'attends. Oui, oui. Oui, appelle les Gestapo aussi. Ouais, ça ce sont les Suisses. Les malgré nous. Alsace entièrement suisse. So there's my petrol station. There it is. But I have to go to the other side. I arrived there last night. I have to cross the little bridge in here for the, you know, for the farmers, a farmer's bridge. And that was the checkerboard church. Where is it? Where I slept. There it is. You can even see it from here. Oh, there it is. So, France is beautiful. I really love France. I would love to live here. People are nice, I speak their language. Beautiful nature, there's everything here. The Mediterranean, the North Sea, mountains, snow, skiing, everything you like. A lot of place, a lot of nature. Forests, real huge forests.
I like the French mentality. Many people don't like it, but I love it. You know, they can be a bit harsh, you know, at the beginning. You know, but if you get to know them, you know, they start laughing. You know, like, yeah. It's the other way around with those bloody Swiss Germans. You know, they smile through their teeth, and hey, we are so clean and nice, and then they got bloody mean. You know. France is all the other way around. And if in Switzerland, if you lie in the streets, you know, in France, you know, they know there's a pity, you know, it's okay, he's got enough, you know, he's a homeless, leave him alone. In Switzerland, the moment you're lying on the ground, you can't defend yourselves anymore, then they come kicking at you everywhere, you know. And if you're strong like America, you know, then they smile through their teeth, or like with Nazi Germany. France has always been betrayed by their politicians, you know, but yeah, I like it here. Yeah, there's tolerance, even, you know, there's a lot of crazy people around, you know, but even they leave you alone, you know, even the cops leave you alone, you know. Yeah. So, well, I tried to get my teeth fixed. I have to be there in the morning. And I knew, you know, I put my alarm this night. It's 5 o'clock in the morning. I just couldn't wake up. When I wake up, I woke up, but I was too lazy, you know. And I thought, well, tomorrow. I knew I wouldn't make it anyway, you know. I had to be there before 10 o'clock. So I just took it easy, you know. Easy does it. So there's the motorway. I have to go the other way. This is why I arrived last night. So I have to go that way, go to Strasbourg. And that was the church I was at, the Freemason Checkerboard Church. Oh, I can't see it with the light in the... Oh, there it is. Probably can even see it from here. So, and this side is going to Strasbourg and to Paris, but the other side is going to Paris. This is the north way to Paris. It's still a quiet motorway, you know, there's motorways in France, you know, there's so many people on there. And this is the only motorway in France where you don't have to pay, in Alsace. And this is why, just going to the south, and if you turn right somewhere, it's going to Paris as well. So, and I'll have to go there. So for French, you know, this is a very quiet motorway. Most motorways are lots of people on it, especially around Paris. Before there were many more lorries, you know, on the motorway, but they all go, you know, they're all being transported by train. So before there were Germans and Belgians and Scandinavians and French, you know, but now there's only East Europeans, Russians and Ukrainians and Polish and Czech, because the West Europeans is all being transported by train. So it's kind of hard, you know, nowadays to find a lorry driver, you know, because I don't speak any Polish or Czech, you know. Before I could speak to them in German and in English, a lot of English and Irish, but you don't see them anymore. It's like gone. And all the even for West European, French and English companies and German companies, they use
East European number plates and East European lorry drivers who are being paid like 1/4 of what they should pay a French lorry driver. So all the French lorry drivers, they're all getting unemployed, you know, and they're giving the jobs to all the East Europeans and who are willing to work for like 25% of the wages. So it was much more fun before and much easier to get a ride, but oh, I'll manage anyway. Yeah. So that's where I'm going now, going to Strasbourg, have my teeth fixed. So here in Strasbourg there's a German military from the Second World War. Obersturmführer died in 1945. That one too. They all got beaten like in 1945. So there's a whole cemetery here in Strasbourg. With these old Germans apparently. And on the other side where the white crosses are, they're all French. And it goes on, you know, behind that white wall there. So they're all French here on that side. It says here, Mort pour la France. Looks like he's from Corsica. Stupid wars, eh? To fight the enemy within, you know, instead. So and here's some more Frenchies. You know, mort pour la France. So where the German crosses are, like there, where it's in grey, like their uniforms or, you know, Feldgau, that's all Germans. And there's even Muslims, you know, like this one here. So first they fought for France and then they got shot to pieces in the Algerian Independence War by the French army, you know. It's so stupid, you know, they even got medals, you know. Here there's some more Arabs there. Stupid wars, you know. So walking around with assault rifles in town in Strasbourg in France. Look at it. Yeah. So we accept the total control, you know. They use a couple of Muslims attack for it, you know. So for us to accept total control. It's getting worse. Never saw these sort of things before, you know. Getting real bad. What's he aiming at now? No, looking for something. Getting weird, eh? Even the pyramid car is in red and white of the two kingdoms, you see. I saw them in Switzerland, I see them here in France as well. So there was no dentist, I have to come back in 2 weeks, more than 2 weeks. Oh well. my whole cheek is hurting. Even goes into the eye. Oh, never mind, you know. Nice obelisks. The symbol of the aristocracy, or the dignity, symbol of the pharaonic dignity.
So this is a famous church, cathedral of Strasbourg. It's a big one. I'm not gonna look all into it, you know. But here's a lot of kings in there, you know. That's the aristocracy with the Pope. Always go together. You know. And the Swiss Guard, of course, killing people everywhere.
Every 10 minutes or every 15 minutes, there's ships with tourists passing by. Well, let's see if we can make them move their hands. Let's see if they're here, when they're here. Well, there they are. Hello! That's not so many. Before it was a lot.
I'm coming up.
Hello! Let's move your hands. Est-ce que tu peux l'expliquer dans 5 minutes ton livre, de quoi il s'agit, et faire une présentation?
Non, j'ai pas préparé ça.
Ou dans 5 minutes?
J'ai pas préparé ça vraiment.
Donc Sébastien de Paris, qui cherche une maison de presse pour publier son livre. Et ça, c'est la première page. Voilà. Donc si quelqu'un veut le publier. Première page. So I'm back here, no dentist, still pain in my mouth and my tooth. Another toothache for a couple of more weeks. Oh. Not easy. Just listen to the froggies in froggy country. So I'm here not very far from the Swiss border. This is a bunker from the First World War. It can't be from the Second World War, you know, because it has been all occupied then, so there was no need, you know, to put a German bunker or somewhere, something in the middle of nowhere. But the front line in the First World War, you see, it's all closed here. It must have been the door here, so they all closed it down, you know, here with a lot of with a pile of earth here. So the front line, you know, the front line between the, you know, the Germans and the French, it went all the way from the Atlantic all the way to Switzerland. And as a coincidence, you know, they just stopped in Switzerland. You know,
instead of, you know, taking a little tour through Switzerland and attack the enemy in the back. It was all, it just stopped, you know. It was all the, you know, the trenches, they are probably here somewhere, or they were here, probably they all closed it down. So, or maybe the bunker, you know, where the general was sitting, you know, with the telephone, was all, you like, a couple of hundred meters behind the lines. So I don't know if it's French or German. The whole country is full of bunkers. And someone put a nice graffiti on it, a nice painting. Well, what else can you do with the bunker, you know? So it's definitely First World War, you know, if you look at the soldiers. Stupid humanity, with all their wars, should just disobey, you know? Even if some of us have to die because we disobey, you know, and they put you in front of a firing squad. If we all disobey, you know, there won't be any more wars. But nobody wants to be the first one, you know, to disobey, and so we're all being massacred instead. Stupid humanity. Yeah, some of us have to make a sacrifice, you know, otherwise we won't get there. And say, no, I'm not going to do your war, you know, I don't feel like it. Piss off. Okay, a couple of hundred will be executed. But if we all refuse, there won't be any more wars, you know. And I feel there's a big one coming up, you know. So here I'm in a nice convertible. The guy just took me on a convertible car. Here's my backpack. Everything open. So here in France. Nice. Oui. Salut. Merci beaucoup. Ciao. Yeah. So this guy just took me in his convertible. Real nice. There he goes. So, you know, even if you don't have any money, you know, you're even taken like in a convertible, you know. Why not? Why not coconuts? Nice Frenchies. So here they're making publicity for the measles. Can you believe it? So they make publicity, so, you know, they want people to inject, you know, all sort of garbage here in Switzerland. Someone parked his airplane here. It's a MiG. A Polish MiG or something. Here in Switzerland. I think this is Polish. This is in Basel, in the industrial complex with two obelisks here. It says Bayela. Yeah, well, they, so you know, if you go in here with the sun hieroglyph, you know. So it's all new. They know what they are doing. And you see, it's the aristocracy, obelisks, you know, Freemason stuff. So they just painted it, you know, on the wall. I don't know what, it's a gallery. It's a famous gallery, yeah. It's sort of a posh thing, you know.
So they know exactly where they are, you know, it's for the pharaohs. So they know, so they can feel at home, you know, among each other. So it's, you know, it's in the middle of an industrial complex here. It's absolutely weird. Absolutely weird. It's all new. I've never seen this before. And I was here like, oh, last year at least. And there's the American flag and the Southern States, you know, the slavery flag. Yeah, it's all here. Yeah, these are the type of things Swissy likes. So you thought this is the Scottish flag, eh? But we're not in Scotland here, this is Switzerland. They're even giving signals with those chemtrails. So now, just any farmer can predict the weather, and if it's going to be so there will be a change of weather now with this year. Yeah. Well, at least the moon is still there.